In a concerted effort to address pressing challenges facing youth, including teenage pregnancies, gender-based violence, and HIV, innovative strategies are being implemented within religious circles. The youth and the religious leaders have held their intergenerational dialogue as a collaborative approach is being championed to foster positive change and promote well-being of young individuals. Praise Mwesigwa, a programs manager at Uganda Youth and Adolescent Health Forum, says that engaging religious leaders is at the forefront of this initiative, with a focus on building partnerships that align with shared goals of community welfare and overall well-being.
Religious leaders give misleading information, but I think it's not really misleading information, but it's how we capture the communication that they make. Yeah, so we know that they are moral and ethical. Their teachings around they surround the moral and ethical values, you know, and they cannot get into a position where they have to start arguing that I have to do this and do that, because they're supposed to bring everyone together. And so it's important that we have such discussions, like where we're having young people and religious leaders really come together on one platform to get to understand what the other thinks about themselves.
The youth explain that stigma and taboos remain significant barriers, as some religious teachings perpetuate societal norms that surround discussions about sexuality.
When it comes to HIV, I mean, not say all, but some religious leaders are actually giving in wrong information, because the fact that instead of them telling people who are HIV positive to take their medication, instead they tell them that, you know what, we can pray about praying is not bad. It's also a good thing. Yeah, it's actually a very good thing, praying about it. But we should give them the correct information, that they can let them take their medicine.
The church is for everyone, and we also seek God the same way it is. We've heard of instances where priests don't keep things confidentiality is not kept to them, which I would encourage most of these guys, those that have done theology, those that are doctors and scientists in their field, to guide them on keeping confidentiality, because it looks as if HIV is breaking news to some people, which for me, to me it may feel something normal. But I look at that person who does not have the audacity to stand, to even speak before the camera and tell people that this is what is going on.
Fred Makubia, a religious leader from Uganda Matters Church, has emphasized the paramount importance of maintaining confidentiality within religious circles. His call serves as a reminder to religious leaders about the sacred trust placed in their hands.
It is ethical, it is significant that every church leader, once somebody has trusted you with their information, it's important that you keep it confidential and don't share it with any other person. Professionally, there are just a few circumstances where you come out and break the confidentiality. And one of those areas, if somebody ever shares with you about issues of suicidal thoughts, either somebody wants to kill themselves or somebody wants to cause harm to the other people, that is when you can professionally come out and break the confidentiality. But apart from that, you are not actually supposed to share any information that your congregant has actually come to share with you.
Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.